What?
You'd like talking about that. Ooh. One is another one.
Another angle,
in.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hungry gonna,
you know, let him do his thing as. Oh, they're baiting right now.
Yeah. Yuve not
oh,
going to
missed.
Get the stun. It's Peanut.
So they play it very cautiously. They slow push into the opponents, and then Life and Ruler come off a recall, and things are disastrous.
Well, Kenny and Peanut have found each other here as Peanut is brawling. Stun comes out with the permafrost here as Deepwater dive from Beryl, but they are trying to punish. Ruler will be able to get it, and no, it's stolen away by Life, but still, first blood to Gen G.
Destructive.
Gang duo also, Steadfast presence is great. That was the bait, though, as the Arctica's shoulder's blocked as well. Peanut taking a lot of damage, though, and Noggery trying to get some work done. The ultimate did come down, and Roach turns up. Picks up the first kill. Canyon tries to take down the Silas, eventually does, as Roach has to flash and survives.
That was uncharacteristically awful.
Well, it was a great knock up there as, okay, Fate's Call utilized, and this is the power of Gen G on the bottom side. Oh my god.
Whoa.
This is all going wrong as Showmaker trying to get something back here. For Damwon, he picks up one of the kills, flashes out of the way of Roach, needs to give him that.
It's going to be highly valuable as we may have Beryl dying yet again. Deepwater Dive is going to get his health back though, and he will be all right. Peanut down here. Control ward in that brush as Roach is getting dove once again. Canyon not going to get pulled back by the Infernal Chains. Another fadeaway ultimate.
Stories, they're really hard to find.
Uh-oh.
Peanut not going to find the abscond there as Death from Below has been picked up. Misses onto Beryl though, and he says, I got a better one. Is going to burn down as Life desperately wants to get out there. And
lead ahead.
There we go.
Let's take a look at how this all transpired. Peanut just swinging a miss right there at the end. He gets the Pike ultimate. He ended up whiffing on it. Beryl not able to do anything.
I'm actually not sure how that missed. It looked like he was in the X. But
yeah.
Well, Peanut's seconds. Back. Shelly not going to be getting any plates as Beryl. Deepwater dive looking for Ruler. Actually turning around aggressively as he does get the stun onto Life. We don't have the Fate's Call, remember, and that is a very dead Jarvan. They're looking to try and take down this outer turret as Peanut prisons the Pike and he immediately falls down, but in comes Damwon. Ruler gonna go golden. Peanut does the same thing, but that's preparing them to just get murdered by this Damwon roster. Roach now alongside Cuvée is trying to get something done, but you can't be a tank if there's no backline to protect. Roach doing a lot of AoE though, as Nuclear doesn't want to be sharing pixels with Canyon right now. Noggery there beside him.
Project Pike is what? I mean,
okay.
What is that?
It's a lull state.
Now, look, I mean, they've actually been playing.
Well, this is not a lull. This is Infernal Chains getting a hell of a lot of value, and a Kalista picking up a kill. Maybe Gen G goes straight to Baron. There is no jungler. This could be the killing fields, though. Damwon, an opportunity, but it's not going to be a smite war. There is no smite available. Blue Trinket spotting for a flank as Life gets out of position, but flags and drags. This is a 24-minute Baron. It's
remember,
not exactly
Kalista.
The fastest. Yeah, exactly. Rend is going to be there for secure. Damwon need to pull the trigger. Otherwise, they're just fighting against the Baron. In goes Noggery. No stun is going to be available, though, as Life goes golden. Puts two people in a baby cage, but Showmaker still doing battle on the back end. A lot of damage comes forward, but Death from Below gets nothing. And Gen G are looking at a Baron.
Collected
and
by Damwon. And let's just take a look at this. So Canyon feels compelled by some cosmic force to go over to the brush, even though they had a line of vision around the Baron.
Yep.
So he needed, it was imperative that he get that vision in the left river brush and ended up losing his life. And then Damwon, they come in here. and they take a team fight, but they can't do anything. As you see, Beryl, he tries to go in there with Death Ruffalo to get something accomplished, and then everyone is flash for flash at the very end. And now we're going to have to see if Dom won game.
Bone Skewer lands onto life, though, and they just don't really care. Inhibitor turret goes down. Inhibitor should follow as Dom won. Not a lot of opportunities, and Roach has found Noggery. Decent stun there as Showmaker makes his way into the back line. A lot of AoE as he's blade surging around. Takes down the Kalista, which is huge news as Beryl comes on in, trying to land that death from below. Doesn't quite get it, and Gen G look to have turned this. Noggery breaks the chains, but it's not going to be enough. Hookshot denied by the Steadfast Presence, and here we go. Game number three is upon us, LS, and Gen G have a chance to bring us to that tiebreaker match.
And Gen G, they're going to be able to raise these last two Nexus turrets. And like you're saying, Atlas, we're going to a game number three.
And if Gen G can do it after that, we are guaranteed at least six games of League of Legends. It is high value LCK